Hello everyone, welcome to Civil Engineering Mastery. Today we shall discuss about static determinacy and static indeterminacy for plane truss. Let us look into the basic assembly of a truss. Here is the simple truss which is having roller support at one end and hinged support at other end. These are all the members. Here are the joints which are connecting all the tie members. This truss has 7 members, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. And the number of joints are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Total of 5 joints and 7 members. This is the basic assembly of a truss. Now, let us discuss few important points about truss. The first point is, trusses can only be loaded at joints. And it can carry only axial load. There will not be any bending moment and shear force in trusses. For example, imagine if we apply the load on the member, what will happen here? The bending moment will develop in the member and it will become a frame. We cannot call this as a truss. So this is the reason trusses can only be loaded at joints. The next point is, when we analyze the truss, the bending moment due to its self-weight of the member should be neglected. As we all know that for any member, the self-weight will act at the CG of the member. Again, what will happen here? Bending moment will develop and we cannot have bending moment in trusses. So, when we analyze the truss, we have to neglect the bending moment due to its self-weight of the member. The third point is, all the members in the trusses should be perfectly straight. We cannot have curved member in trusses because if we have curved member like this in trusses, again the bending moment will develop, it will become a frame. So always all the members in the trusses should be perfectly straight. What are all the important points in trusses? The first point is, trusses can carry only axial load and there will not be any bending moment and shear force in trusses. The next one is, bending moment due to its self-weight of the member should be neglected when we analyze the truss. And the third one is, all the members in the truss should be perfectly straight. We cannot have curved members in trusses. Now let's look into the determinacy and stability for plane truss. For internal indeterminacy, the formula is M plus R is equal to 2J. If this satisfies, then we call this as a determinate truss. If M plus R is greater than 2J, then we call that as an indeterminate truss. If M plus R is less than 2J, we can call that as an unstable truss. External determinacy. If number of reactions are less than 3, we call it as unstable truss. If number of reactions are equal to 3, 3 is the number of equilibrium equations here, then we call that as a determinate truss. If number of reactions are greater than 3, then we call that as indeterminate truss. Now, the question is, how do we arrive that M plus R is equal to 2J? Let us discuss that in detail now. How do we find out the static indeterminacy of a truss? Static indeterminacy is equal to total number of unknowns minus total number of available equilibrium equations. What is total number of unknowns? Total number of unknowns is equal to member forces plus external reactions. These member forces, we can represent it as M, which is equal to number of members in the truss. For this particular type of truss, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7 members. And external reaction, we can represent it as R, which is equal to number of reactions, number of external reactions. For this truss, we have roller support one reaction, and for hinged support two reaction. Totally we have three external reaction for this truss. And the next one is total number of available equilibrium equations. This we can represent it as 2 into J. What is this 2? For a 2D truss, at each joint, we have 2 number of equilibrium equation. That is, summation of Fx is equal to 0 and summation of Fy is equal to 0. So, we can write the total number of available equilibrium equation as 2 into joint. 2 is the number of available equilibrium equation at each joint. So for this truss, we have 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 joints. Each joint we have 2 number of equilibrium equations. So finally, we can arrive static indeterminacy is equal to m plus r minus 2j. Total static indeterminacy is equal to external indeterminacy plus internal indeterminacy. When we can say the structure is statically determinate, if the external indeterminacy and internal indeterminacy are equal to 0, then the structure is said to be statically determinate. As we all know that external indeterminacy is equal to number of reactions minus number of available equilibrium equation, that is R minus 3. Static indeterminacy is equal to external indeterminacy plus internal indeterminacy. We know the static indeterminacy which we have arrived, that M plus R minus 2J. And we know the external indeterminacy. From this we have to find out the internal indeterminacy. Internal indeterminacy is equal to static indeterminacy minus external indeterminacy. By solving this, we can get the internal indeterminacy is equal to m plus 3 minus 2j. Till now, we have discussed about a basic assembly of a truss, few important points about a truss, and how to find out the static indeterminacy of a truss. Now, let's move on to few examples. We are going to find out the static indeterminacy for this truss. What is the formula for static indeterminacy? It is external indeterminacy plus internal indeterminacy. First, we have to find out the external indeterminacy, which is equal to number of reactions minus number of equilibrium equations. We have total of 3 number of reactions here for roller support 1 and for hinged support 2 reactions, and the number of equilibrium equations are 3. So we have external indeterminacy is 0. Therefore, this truss is said to be externally determinate. The next one is internal indeterminacy. What is the formula for internal indeterminacy? Which is m plus 3 minus 2j. M is the number of members. We have totally 10 number of members for this particular truss. Plus 3 minus 2 is the number of available equilibrium equations. And number of joints are 6 here. You can see total number of joints are 6. So we have internal indeterminacy is 1. Therefore, this truss is said to be internally indeterminate. Overall static indeterminacy is equal to 1. Hence, this truss is said to be statically indeterminate to the first degree. Here we have another type of truss which is having both end at hinged support. We have to find out the static indeterminacy for this truss. Static indeterminacy is equal to external indeterminacy plus internal indeterminacy. External indeterminacy is equal to number of reactions minus number of equilibrium equations. We have for hinged support 2 reactions, and here also the hinged support 2 reactions. So totally we have 4 number of reactions. 4 minus 3 is the number of equilibrium equations. So our external indeterminacy is 1. Therefore, this stress is said to be externally indeterminate. Internal indeterminacy is equal to m plus 3 minus 2j. M is the number of members. For this stress, we have totally we have 13 number of members. 13 plus 3 minus 2 is the number of equilibrium equations and j is the number of joints. We have 8 number of joints. So, the internal indeterminacy is 0. Therefore, this stress is internally determinate. The overall static indeterminacy is equal to 1. We can say that the structure is statically indeterminate to the first degree. Here is another example. Static indeterminacy is equal to external indeterminacy plus internal indeterminacy. External indeterminacy is number of reactions minus number of equilibrium equations. We have totally 4 number of reactions here. So our external indeterminacy is 1. Therefore, this stress is externally indeterminate. Internal indeterminacy is equal to m plus 3 minus 2j. We have totally 21 number of members for this stress. 21 plus 3 minus 2 into total of totally we have 10 number of joints. So 2 into 10. Our internal indeterminacy is 4. Therefore, this stress is internally indeterminate. Here is the here we have a different case. Both this stress is both externally indeterminate and internally indeterminate. So the overall static indeterminacy is equal to 5. Hence, the structure is statically indeterminate to the fifth degree. The next example, static indeterminacy is equal to external indeterminacy plus internal indeterminacy. Number of reactions are 3 here, total number of reactions are 3. We have external indeterminacy 0. So this stress is externally determinate. Internal indeterminacy is equal to m plus 3 minus 2j. We have totally 9 number of members. 9 plus 3 minus 2 into number of joints, total number of joints are 6. So internal indeterminacy is equal to 0. So this is internally indeterminate and externally determinate. Therefore, overall static indeterminacy is equal to 0. Then this stress is said to be statically determinate. This stress is little different from what we have discussed till now. This stress has two internal hinges. What is the function of the internal hinge here? This internal hinge is separating this one member into two members. So when we count the number of joints, we have to count this internal hinges too. For this stress, we have totally we have 10 number of joints because this internal hinge is dividing this member. Now let's find out the static indeterminacy, which is external indeterminacy plus internal indeterminacy. As we know that external indeterminacy is equal to r minus 3, which we got as 0. Therefore, this stress is externally determinate. Internal indeterminacy is equal to m plus 3 minus 2j. We have overall number of members is 16 here. 16 plus 3 minus 2 into total number of joints are 10, as I already told. So we have our internal indeterminacy is equal to minus 1. Therefore, this stress is internally unstable. Total static indeterminacy is equal to minus 1. Hence, this stress is unstable. Friends, hope you all like this video. Please do comment, like and share, and don't forget to subscribe for more videos. Thank you.